having only one ones. So single one can't be grouped. So another thing, a grouping is if you have 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 4. That is, if you are having 2 ones, then you can group a pair. If you are having 4 ones, you can group into an quad. If you are having 8 ones, you can group into a octet. And if you are having 14 ones, also you can group. So you can go for grouping only if you are having 2 to the power number of ones. So here you are having only 1 ones. So 1 ones you can't group. You have to group it individually. So the value of this cell is 0, 0. The variable here is A bar, and variable here is B bar. So the expression is A bar B bar. So when you're having only 1 1, you can group. You have to group individually, and the expression what you're getting is the value of this cell, that is 0 0. Yeah, the variable here is A, so 0 means A bar. The variable here is B, so B bar. Next, having a 1 here, so the value of the cell is 0 1. The variable here is 0. 0 means A bar, 1 means B, so A bar B. Next is having 1 here. So here also the value of the cell is 1 0. You have to group it individually. The value of the cell is 1 0. So the variable here is A, and the variable is B bar. So the expression is A B bar. Next, having a 1 at this place. So if you have to group it individually, the value of the cell is 1 1. So the expression is A B. Next, we are going for 3-variable map. So if you are having 3 variables, your K map will be having 8 cells. Your K map will be having 8 cells. That is, 2 to the power 3 is 8. So 8 cells you will be having. So you will be having 8 minterms. So these are the 8 combination of 3 variables. So 0 means A bar, B bar, C bar, then A bar, B bar, C, then A bar, B, C bar, then A bar, B, C. Similarly for 1 1 1, A, B, C. So each cell represents one of these minterms. The value of this cell is 0. This is 1. This is 3, and this is 2. Already I have told you that in K-map you are following gray code and not binary code. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and then only 1, 1. So this code is a gray code. Why we are using a gray code means, by using gray code only we will be getting adjacent cells 1 bit change. The value of the cell is 0, 0, 0. The value of this cell is 0, 0, 1. The value of this cell is 0, 1, 1. Now you check. So here you are having 0, 0, 0. So here you are having 0, 0, 1. So only 1 bit is changing. Now you are considering these 2 cells. Here you are having 0, 0, 0. Here you are having 0, 1, 0. Only this bit is changing. What is the value of this cell? 1, 0, 0. So only 1 bit is changing. So here in K-map, adjacent cells differ by only 1 bit. And these are the decimal values of this cells. This is 0, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6. be careful, it is gray code, so only we are getting like this 0 1 3 2 4 5 7 6, not 4 5 6 7, 4 5 7 6. So how we are getting this 4 means 1 0 0, multiplying the respective row and respective column. So 1 0 0 is 4, so 1 0 1 is 5, 1 1 1 is 7, 1 1 0 is 6. Now in a two variable k map, if all of your cells are 1, then the expression is 1. Now we are coming for the three variable map. Here the variables what you are taken are a, b and c. If you want, you can take x, y and z, no problem. So here the row wise you are having only one variable, and in the column wise you are having two variable. First possibility is having ones in all the 8 cells. If you are having one in all the 8 cells, then the expression is 1. Whatever may be the cell, whether it is 2 variable or 3 variable or 4 variable or 5 variable, if you are having ones in all the cells, then the expression is 1. Next possibility is having 4 adjacent 1 like this. So if you are having 4 adjacent 1 like this, then you can group. Because grouping, we can go for, if you are having 2 ones, you can group. You can, if you are having 4 ones, you can group. If you are having 8 ones, you can group. If you are having 16 ones, you can group. If you are having 32 ones, you can group. The thing is, you can group 2 to the power n. Once if you have, once you, if you are having, then you can group. So this is a way of grouping if you are having 4 1 like this. Now how to write the expression? So when considering this grouping, we have considered this row and these 4 columns for grouping. So in these 4 columns, first we check the value of b. Here the value of b is 0. Here the value of b is 0, but here the value of b is 1. So the value of b is changing. So it's not same in all the 4 columns. So we can neglect this b. Now you check c. Here the value is 0. Here the value is 1. So the value of c also changing. It is not same in all the 4 columns. So no need to consider the variable c also. But we are having only one row. In that row, the value of a is 0. So since it is 0 and the variable is a, it is a bar. The expression is a bar. So this is the way to group 4 1 if you are getting like this. Next possibility is getting 4 1 in these positions. So you can group like this. So for this grouping also, we have considered one row and 4 columns. In these 4 columns, the value of b is not same. Here it is 0, here it is 0, but here it is 1. So no need to consider b. Now you consider c. The value of c is 0 here, c is 1 here. So the value of c is also changing. No need to consider c. So only we have to consider this 1. The variable here is a. So f is equal to a is the expression. Next possibility is getting 4 ones like this. So if you are getting 4 adjacent 1 like this, then you can group in this manner. Now for this grouping, we have considered 2 rows and 2 columns. So in the 2 rows, the value of a is changing. Here it is 0, here it is 1. So no need to consider this value a. Now consider b. The value of b is 0 here and 0 here. So it is not changing. So we have to consider. So what is the number 0? 0 means b bar. Then you take the value c. Here it is 0. Here it is 1. So the value of c is changing. If it is changing, no need to consider. So the value of expression is f is equal to t bar. So if you are having 4, 1 like this, then you can group like this, and the expression is f is equal to b bar. Next, if you are having 4 adjacent 1 like this, so if you are having 4 adjacent 1 like this, you can group in this manner. While grouping, we have considered these 2 rows and these 2 columns. The value of a is not same in these 2 rows, so no need to consider a. Now you check b. So here it is 1, here it is 1. So the value of b is not changing. So we have to consider, since it is 1, we are writing as b. Value of c is not same. Here it is 1, here it is 0. So no need to consider the value c. So the expression is f is equal to b. Next, having 4, 1 like this. So if you fold this K map, these 2 ones and these 2 ones will come closer. So if you fold like this, then you will be getting these 4, 1 like this. So we can group in this manner. So for this grouping, we have considered 2 rows. In these 2 rows, the value of A is changing, so no need to consider this A. So we have considered these 2 columns. In these 2 columns, the value of B is changing. Here it is 0, here it is 1. But the value of C is not changing. Since the value of B is changing, no need to consider, but the value of C is not changing. So we have to consider C. But the value here is 0. Since it is 0, it is C bar. Now, having 4, 1 like this, if you are having 4, 1 like this, then we can group in this manner. So for this grouping also, we have considered these 2 rows. In these 2 rows, value of B, A is changing, no need to consider. So the value of B also changing, it is changing, so no need to consider. So the value of C is not changing, and it is 1 in both the places, so you have to take it as C. So next possibility is having 2, 1 like this. If you are having 2, 1 like this, we can group in this manner. For this grouping, we have considered these 2 rows and only 1 column. So here the value of A is changing in these 2 rows. So no need to consider the variable A, and we have to consider this B and C. So since it is 0, it is B bar, and it is 0, it is C bar. Next possibility is to having 2, 1 like this. If you are having 2, 1 like this, we can group in this manner. Here also the same way. So we are taking these 2 rows and this 1 column. So here the value is changing, so no need to consider A. So we have to consider only B and C. The value of B is 0, so it is B bar and it is C. Next possibility is having 2, 1 like this, so we can group in this manner, and the expression is BC. If you are having 2, 1 like this, then you can group in this manner. The expression is BC bar. If you are having 2, 1 like this, you can group in this manner. And while grouping, here we have considered only 1 row and 2 columns. Here in these 2 columns, the value of B is not changing, but the value of C is changing. So the value of B is 0 here, so it is B bar, and we have considered only 1 row in 1, and that row the value is 0. 0 means A bar. So the expression is A bar B bar is the expression. Next one, we are having 2, 1 like this, so we can group in this manner. Here also we have considered this 1 row and these 2 columns. In these 2 columns, value of C is not changing, and value of B is changing, so no need to consider B, and we have to consider only C. Since it is 1, it is C. Similarly, in this row, the value is 0, so A bar. So next, you are having 2, 1 like this. Here the expression is A bar B. If you are having 2, 1 like this, then we can group in this manner, and the expression is F is equal to A B bar. So another possibility is having 2, 1 like this. You can group in this manner, and the expression is A C. Next possibility is two having 2, 1 like this. The expression is AB. Next possibility is having two ones like this. So if you fold this K map, this two ones will come closer and it will be adjacent. So we will check. So if you fold these two one will come closer. Now already I have told you that we can group two ones if those two ones are placed in cells which are having only one bit change. So what is the value of this bit? The cell 0 0 0. What is the value of this cell? 0 1 0. So there is only one bit change. So these two ones can be grouped. So we can group these two one like this. So for grouping, we have considered only one row and these two columns. So here the value of A is 0, so it is A bar. And in these two columns, the value of B is changing. Here it is 0 and here it is 1. But the value of C is not changing, 0. So C bar. So this is the way for grouping, and the expression is F is equal to A bar C bar. Next possibility is having two one like this. So we can group in this manner, and the expression is we have considered this row and these two columns. So we are having only one row, so we have to take this variable. Since it is one, it is A, and in these two columns, C is not changing and the value is 0, so it is C bar. Next possibility is having only one one. So if you are having only one one, you have to group it individually. But the expression is nothing but the value of the cell. The value of the cell is 0 0 0. The variable here is A, so A bar. The variable here is B, so B bar, C bar. So this is the expression. So the value of the cell is 0 0 0. Here the variable is A, here the variable is B and C. 0 means A bar, 0 means B bar, 0 means C bar. Okay. Next is 4 variable map. So 4 variable map will be having 16 cells and each cell represent one of the 16 minterms. So here also we have written the numbers in gray code. So the 4 variables are A, B, C, D. If you want, you can take W, X, Y, Z also. So value of this cell is nothing but this 0, 0 into this 0, 0. This row into this column. This row into this column. Value of this cell is 0, 0, 0, 1. The value of this cell is 0, 0, 1, 1. The value of this cell is 1, 1, 1, 1. Now, these are the 16 minterms. Now, these are the decimal values of the cells. So, here the value of the list 0, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, 0 is 0. So, if you want to know, you write 8, 4, 2, 1. Then we can check the value. So the value of the cell is 1 1 0 0. 1 1 0 0. So we are having 1 in the place of 8 and 1 in the place of 4. So 8 plus 4 is 12. So we have written 12 here. The value of this cell is 9. So here the value is 1 0 0 1. 1 0 0 1. So you're having 1 in the place of 8 and 1 in the place of 1. So 8 plus 1 is 9. So please look here how we are writing the numbers 0, 1, 3, 2. So since it is gray code, adjacent cells differ by only one bit. So while writing decimal number, you should be careful. 0, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6, then 8, 9, 11, 10. Then 12, 13, 15, 14. then the first possibility in the four in a four variable map, the first possibility is having all ones in the 16 cells. If you're having one all ones in the 16 cells, then the expression is 1. I already told you that whatever may be the map, whether it is 2 or 3 or 4, if you're having ones in all the cells, then the expression is 1. So this is the grouping and the expression is 1. Next possibility, having 8 ones. So in 4 variable map, maximum cells is 16. So 2 power 4 is 16. Next is 2 power 3, that is 8. So next possibility is having 8 adjacent ones. So if you're having 8 adjacent ones like this, then you can group in this manner. So for this grouping, we have considered this 4 rows and 2 columns. So in this 4 rows, the value of A is not same. Here it is 0, here it is 0, but here it is 1. Since the value of A is changing in this 4 rows, no need to consider this variable A. Similarly, the variable B, it is 0 here, it is 1 here. So the variable is, the value is changing. So no need to consider the variable B. Now you take the variable C. Here it is 0, here also it is 0. So we have to consider C. Since it is 0, it is C bar. Now you consider the variable D. Here it is 0 and here it is 1. Since it is changing, we can neglect. So the expression is F is equal to C bar. Next possibility is having 8 adjacent 1 like this. So if you are having 8 adjacent 1s, you can group in this manner. And the expression is F is equal to D. Here in these 4 rows, the value of A and B are not same. So we can neglect. So in these 2 columns, the value of D is same. So it is, since it is 1, F is equal to D is a expression. Next possibility having 8 ones like this. Here the expression is F is equal to C, because the value of C is same. And since it is 1, it is F is equal to C. Next possibility is having 8 ones like this. So if you fold this map, this 8 adjacent, this 8 ones will come adjacent. So for this grouping, we have considered these 4 rows and these 2 columns. In these 4 rows, the value of A and B are varying. So we can neglect these 2 variables, and the value of D is same. So since it is 0, it is D bar. So F is equal to D bar is a expression. The next possibility is like this. So here you can group in this manner. Here we have considered 2 rows and 4 columns. In these 2 rows, the value of B is not changing. So since it is 0, it is B bar. So in these 4 columns, the value of C and D are changing. So no need to consider the C and D. Next possibility is having 8 adjacent 1 like this. Here the you can group in this manner. And the expression is F is equal to A bar. Next is having 8 adjacent 1 like this. Here also we have considered these 2 rows. In these 2 rows, value of B is not changing. Since it is 1, it is B. In this 4 columns, the value of C and D are changing. So the expression is F is equal to B. Next is having 8 adjacent 1 like this. The expression is F is equal to A. Next is having 4 adjacent 1 like this. So we can group in this manner. So for this grouping, we have considered these 2 rows. In these 2 rows, the value of A is not changing. So since it is 0, it is A bar. Then in these 2 columns, the value of C is not changing. Since it is 0, it is C bar. Similarly, having 4 adjacent 1 like this. So we can group in this manner. So the expression is B C bar. Similarly, 4 adjacent 1s, the expression is F is equal to A C bar. So if you're having 4 adjacent 1 like this, then you can group in this manner. So if you fold this K map, these four ones will be adjacent. So we can group. The expression is B bar C bar. Next is having four adjacent one like this. We can group in this manner. Expression is F is equal to A bar D. Next is having four adjacent one like this. Expression is F is equal to BD. Next is four one like this. So the expression is F is equal to BD. Next is like this. You can group in this manner and the expression is F is equal to B bar D. Next possibility is having four one like this. Here also we are using these two rows. In these two rows, value of A is not changing. So A bar. Here the value of C is not changing. So A bar C is the expression. Next is having 4 on like this. So here the expression is F is equal to BC. Next F is equal to AC. Next F is equal to B bar C. This is the important thing. Having 4 adjacent ones in the 4 ones in the corners. So if you fold, these 4 ones will be coming near. So we can group. So in this way you can group these 4 adjacent ones. So for this grouping we have considered these two rows and these two columns. So here the value of B is not changing, it is B bar. Here the value of D is not changing. Since it is 0, it is B bar. This is the next possibility is like this. So here also the expression is A bar D bar. This is the next possibility. This is the next possibility. The expression is F is equal to A D bar. So next is having 4 adjacent one like this. If you are having 4 adjacent one, you can group in this manner. So in this grouping, we have considered 4 rows and only one column. In this 4 rows, the value of A and B are changing. And since it we are using only one column, we have to take this value. Since it is 0, 0, it is C bar, D bar. Next possibility is having 4 one like this. So we can group in this manner and the value of expression is F is equal to C bar D. Next is having 4 1 like this and the expression is C D. Next is having 4 1 like this, the expression is C D bar. Next is having 2 1 like this. If you are having 2 adjacent 1 like this, then you can group in this manner. So for this grouping we have considered one row and two column. So since here we have taken only one row, you have to consider this variables A and B. So A bar, since it is 0, it is A bar, B bar. In these two columns, the value of C is not changing. Since it is 0, you have to take it as C bar. So this is the first possibility. So this is the next possibility. If you are having two ones like this, then you can group in this manner. Then the expression is A bar, B bar, D. Next possibility is having 2 1 like this. The expression is B bar C bar D. So next possibility is having ones like this. So here you are not having any adjacent ones. So here you are having one, 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 and here you are having one. So you can't group this ones because it is not adjacent. So you have to group it individually and you have to write the expression. The expression for this one is A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar. Expression for this one is A bar, B bar, C, D. Similarly, for this one, A, B, C bar, D bar. This one, A, B, C, D. This one, A, B bar, C, D bar. So this is the expression for this K map. So here no way to group because the ones are not adjacent. So after getting this, this is the next problem. So the next possibility is having 4, 8, 1 like this and 2, 1 like this. So this 8, 1 we can group in this manner. Can write group in this manner, and these 2 1s. So can group in this manner. So in K map, our aim is to group all the ones. First point, we have to group all the ones. Second point, after grouping, we have to get minimum number of terms as well as, and the terms must contain minimum number of literals. So one small example I will tell. Now, I have grouped this 8 ones. So after grouping 8 ones, if I group these 2 ones, the expression what I am getting is, expression for this one is, here we have taken 4 rows and 2 columns to get this group. In this 4 rows, the value of A and B is changing, but the value of C is not changing in these 2 columns. So C bar. Now the expression for this group is, for this grouping we have considered this row and these 2 columns. So we have to take this A bar B. Since it is only one row, we have to kind of take this row variables A bar B. Now in these 2 columns, the variable C is not changing. So you are getting A bar B C. How many literals you are having in the second term? 3 literals you are having. So I have already told you that in K map, our aim is to group all the ones. So all the ones must get grouped. Second point is more important. So the term what you are getting must have minimum number of literals. So if you group these 2 only, you will be getting 3 literals in the term. So if you group this 4 ones, this is overlapping. You can overlap in KMap. Okay. So if you group these 4 ones, the expression is, for this grouping these 4 ones, we have considered these 4 columns and only 1 row. So you can take this A bar B. So A bar B we have taken, and in these 4 columns, the value of C and D are not same. So we can neglect these 2 variables. So the expression is F is equal to C bar plus A B. So after getting the terms individually, you have to put plus. So if you're having ones like this, the first grouping is like this. We'll be grouping these 8 ones. So after grouping these 8 ones, we may have a tendency to group these 2 ones, but we should not go for this, because if there is a possibility of grouping 4 ones, then we have to consider that only, because grouping 4 ones will give only 2 literal, and grouping 2 ones will give 3 literal. So the aim of our K map is to get minimum number of literals. All the ones should be grouped. And the second point is, the in the expression we must get minimum terms and minimum number of literals. So the next group is like this. So the expression for this one is C bar, and the expression for this one is A bar B. So next we are going for a problem. So till now we have studied what is K map, in the two variable k-map will be having how many cells, four variable k-map will be having how many cells, what are the possibilities, wherever we can get ones, how we can group, what are the expressions that are we have studied. Now we are going to do problems. The first problem is reduce the following function to its minimum SOP form. So we have to reduce this function to SOP form. They have given the Boolean expression. This is a Boolean expression. This Boolean expression is having four variables, that is A, B, C, D. It is having four variables. And how many terms it is having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is a Boolean expression. And this Boolean expression is having four variables and eight terms. Next one, all the terms is having all the four variables. So it is in standard SOP form. Okay, this is in standard SOP form. How many variables it is having? Four variables it is having. Now they have given the expression in Boolean form. Now we are converting this Boolean expression to binary form. So if you, these are the min terms. In min terms, if you are having a complemented literal, you have to put 0. So if you are having uncomplemented literal, you have to put 1. So 0, 0, 0, 1. So A bar means 0, B bar means 0, C bar means 0, D means 1. So this is the binary value. The decimal equivalent of 0, 0, 1 is 1. Next is A bar, B, C bar, D. A bar means 0, B means 1, C bar means 0, D means 1. So we are getting 0, 1, 0, 1. So how to find the value means, if you want, you can write 8, 4, 2, 1. 0, 1, 0, 1. So you are having 1 in the place of 1 and 4. So 4 plus 1 is 5. Like that, we have converted all the min terms into binary. Then we have converted all the binary into decimal. Then how many variables you are having? We are having 4 variables. So we have drawn a 4 variable k-map we have drawn. Then what are the variables A, B, C, D? So we have written A, B, C, D. So the question is in what form? SOP form. So if your question is in SOP form, then you have to plot ones in the respective numbers. So here you are having 1. So in the place of 1, you have to put 1. In the place of 5, you have to put 1. So how to write this decimal value means 0, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6. This value is nothing but this one. 0, 1, do this one. 0, 0. So decimal equivalent of 0, 1, 0, 0 is 4. Similarly, we have written all the things. So 5, 7, 6, 12, 13, 15, 11. So this is plotting. So since the question is in SOP, you have to plot ones. Next, we have plotted ones. Now, what is our usual procedure? Usual procedure is, this is this four variable map will be having 16 cells. The first thing what we will be doing in a 16 and four variable map is we'll be checking whether we are having 16 ones. So it is not having 16 adjacent ones. Then we will be checking for 8 adjacent ones. Do you have 8 adjacent ones? No, having not, we are not having 8 adjacent ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're having 8 ones, but the 8 ones are not adjacent. Then we will be checking for 4 adjacent ones. So we'll be grouping like this. 4 adjacent ones we'll be grouping. Then we'll be grouping. This one is ungrouped. We'll be grouping like this. Then here you are having 1, 1. Will be grouping like this. Here you are having 1, 1, will be grouping like this. Here you are having 1, 1, will be grouping like this. Now, this problem is a very important problem. you must be careful. Why? Because I already told you that in K-map, first condition is all one should be grouped. Second one, the expression what you are getting must have minimum number of terms and minimum number of literals. Now consider this quad. Quad means grouping four ones. So in this problem, even if you are not grouping this four ones, the condition is getting satisfied. Why? Because so how will be grouping means actually you have to group like this. So you have to group these two one into pair, these two one into pair, these two one into pair, and these two one into pair. But usually we will go for four adjacent one. Again, if you are grouping this four ones, you will be getting one more term. So without this quad itself, the condition is getting satisfied. All the ones are getting grouped. All the ones are getting grouped. So if you consider again, you consider this quad, then you will be getting one term extra in your expression. So one term extra means you need one more gate. That is extra cost. So it is a redundant one. So this is wrong. So this is a important problem. So you should be careful, and you have to group only like this. That is, you have to group this pair, this pair, this pair, and this pair. So what is the expression for this one? You have taken these two rows and this one column. In these two rows, value of A is not changing, so it is A bar. Here having only one column, so C bar D. So if you consider this grouping, then it is redundant and the answer is wrong. Now this is the correct way of grouping, and this is the answer. The expression for this one is A bar C bar D. Expression for this one is A bar B C. A bar B C. Expression for this one is A B C bar. Expression for this one is A C D. Okay. So we have completed the problem. So we are having next problem. So here you are having reduce the given Boolean function. This Boolean function is in POS form. So here you are having some sum, that sum you have ANDed together. So this is in POS form. So if question is in POS, then you have to plot zeros. That is the first thing. You have to plot zeros. If it is in SOP, you have to plot ones. And if it is POS, you have to plot zeros. So another important thing is in POS, for complementary literal, you have to put 1, and for uncomplimented literal, you have to put 0. So in the next slide, I will clearly show. So if this is max term, the given thing is max term. So instead of A bar, you have to put 1. B bar, you have to put 1. For C, you have to put 0. For D, you have to put 0. Similarly, here also, A bar, you have to put 1, B bar you have to put 1, C bar you have to put 1, and for T you have to put 0. Then you have to convert this binary to decimal. What is 1? A, if you put 8421, what is this value? 1100 means you are having 1 in the place of 8 and 8 in the place of 4. So you will be getting 12. Next is 1110, it is 14. So we are converting. So next is, so for A bar, you have to put 1. Similarly, b bar 1, c bar 1, d bar 1, sorry, d bar 1. So the decimal value is 15. Similarly, we have to convert all the max terms to binary. Then we have to convert that binary to decimal. Next, we have to plot zeros in the respective numbers. So we have converted that decimal that binary into decimal, and we have got some numbers. So on the corresponding numbers, so this is 0, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6, 8, 9, 11, 10, 12, 13, 15, 14. So we have got some numbers. On that number, that numbers is 0, 0, then 7, 6, then 8, then 12, 13, 15, 14. So we have got these numbers. So we have plotted the zero since the question is in. So now we are going to group. So first we will be checking for four adjacent zeros. So here you are having four adjacent zeros. So you can group like this. Then here we can have another four adjacent zeros. You can group like this. Now you are having two zeros left ungrouped. That is here 10 and here 10. These two you can group in this way. So we have this is the first group, this is the second group, and this is the third group. So now we are going to write the expression. Actually, we have to write the expression in POS, but first writing the expression in SOP, then converting it in POS, it will be easy. So first, similar to our SOP, first we will check what is the expression for this four zeros. So here we have used this row and these four columns. In these four columns, the value of C and D are not same. So we can neglect this C and D, and you have to take this A and B. So we have taken A and B. Then we are coming to the next four, that is next quad. So we have taken these two rows. In these two rows, value of B is not changing. B is 1. So B. In these two columns, C is not changing. So you are getting B, C. Next, we are going to write the expression for this pair. So we have here, we have taken these two rows. In these two rows, value of B is not changing. So since it is 0, we have written as B, B bar. So here you have to take C bar and D bar. So you are getting B bar, C bar, D bar. Now this expression is in SOP. Now we have to convert it. We have to convert it into POS. How to convert means wherever you are having complement, you uncomplement. So if you are having bar, remove that bar. If you are having and, you add plus. If you are having plus, you add and. So here B bar means B. You are having an and, so you put a plus. Then C bar, you put C. Then you are having an and, you put a plus. Then D bar, D. Then put a bracket. Instead of this plus, you put and. Then A means A bar. Indu means plus. D means B bar. Plus means dot. Then B plus C. So B bar plus C bar. So we have written the expression in SOP. Then we have converted. How to convert means if you are having a complement literal, uncomplement it. If you are having a true literal, complement it. If you are having a dot, you make it as plus. If you are having a plus, you make it as dot. Now, next problem is implement the reduce using mapping expression. F is equal to product of M. Product of M. 2, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14. So, the question is, the given question is in POS. Why? Because here you are having product and capital M. So, it is POS. The given numbers are 2, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14. So, how many? So, here the largest number is 14. In order to represent 14, you need minimum 4 bits. So, how many variables are there? 4 variables. So, we have to draw a 4 variable map. Since the variables are not mentioned, we are taking it as A, B, C, D. Then, it's a question is in POS, you are plotting zeros in the respective numbers. So, in the place of 2, we are in the place of 2, we have put 0. In the place of 8, you have put 0. In the place of 9, we have put 0. In the place of 11, 10, we have plotted. So, we have plotted zeros in respect to numbers. So, in the given numbers, in the cells, we have plotted zeros. Next step is we have to group. So, first we will be checking for, since this is a 4 variable map, we will be checking for 16 zeros. There is no 16 zeros. Then we will be checking for 8 adjacent zeros. There is no 8 adjacent zero. Next we will be checking for 4 adjacent zero. First we have got 4 adjacent zero. Next, here also you are having 4 adjacent zero. Then we are having only 1 zero ungrouped. So we can group in this manner. Can have a pair. So now in animation we can clearly say so for this group the expression is for this grouping we have considered this row and these four columns. In these four columns, the value of C and D is changing. So, we are having only this what row. So, it is nothing but A, B bar. First, we are writing in SOP and then we are converting. So, it will be easy. Next, for this grouping, we have taken these two rows. In these two rows, A is not changing. And in these two columns, D is not changing. Since it is bar, it is D bar. Now, next, we are coming to this pair. For this pair, we have taken these two rows. In these two rows, D is not changing. So, B bar and C, D bar. Now, we are going to convert this SOP into POS. So, A means A bar. So, since it is dot, you put plus. The B bar means B. Bracket. Then plus means dot, A means A bar, D here you will be having a dot, so plus D bar means D. Then you are having plus, you change it to dot. Then D bar means B, C means C bar, D bar means D. So this is the expression. So for this, what is the expression? B bar, C bar, D. So for this one the grouping is expression is d c bar d, and for this group is a bar plus d, and for this one is a bar plus b. So this is a, actually this is b bar plus c bar plus d for this pair, and for this group it is a bar plus d, and this for quad it is a bar plus b. So the answer is a bar plus b into a bar plus d into b plus c bar plus d. So first you write the expression in SOP, then you convert it into POS, you will be get the correct answer. Okay, so there is a small error while typing. So the expression for this is something but b plus c bar plus d. Okay, this is the answer. So next, another problem. So simplify the given expression f of x y z is equal to 1 3 4 5 in POS form. So we have to simplify the given function in POS form. They were given question is in SOP 1 3 4 5. How many variables? 3 variables. With 3 variables we can write from 0 to 7. So the given question is in SOP, the given numbers are 1 3 4 5. So we can we'll be having the numbers from 0 to 7. So the missing numbers are 0 2 6 7. So we have written the POS. So since the question is in POS, we have to plot zeros. And we have plotted zeros in the place of 0, 2, 6 and 7. Then we are going for grouping. So these two ones we can group like this, and these two ones we can group like this pair. So the expression for this is, for this grouping we have considered this row and these two columns. Here the variables are x, y, z. So in the map you have to write it as x, y, z. So since there is only one row, we have to consider this x. Since it is 0, it is x bar. In these two columns the value of z is not changing, this z bar. Plus for this group it is x, and here the way y is not changing, so y x bar z bar plus x y. So now the expression is in SOP, we have to convert it into POS. Since the they are asking us to simplify in POS, we have to write the answer in POS. Converting to POS means if you are having a complement and literal, you uncomplemented. If you are having a dot, you put plus. Into, if you are having plus, you put into. Then x bar plus y bar. Now the expression is x plus z into x bar plus y bar. So the expression for this one is x bar plus y bar. Then for this one, x into x plus z. So it is better to first write the expression in SOP, then you convert it to POS. But while writing the exam, you rub that SOP, the expression SOP, you rub it, and you write only the answer in POS. Okay, so it will be very easy.